Hey, what's up, garden friends? Jeff, your tropical plant party. How's everybody doing? Hope you're good. I am great. Time to do some bonsai.
See, my table's still set up from doing that coconut palm video. I was gonna clean up and I was like, let's just go with it. It's fine. Some time ago, I picked up some plants and had mentioned that I was going to use them for bonsai. Some people commented, asked if I would do a video on it, and I thought, sure, why not? Been sitting here, looked at my pots, trying to make up my mind as far as which ones I want to use and those sorts of things, and thought we should talk about what do you need to think about when getting started with a bonsai. See, the first thing, the most important thing, is going to be your plant, right? Yeah, you need to be able to pick out a plant. That's kind of, you know, the most important part. You need to think about what works for you, your environment, your growing style. Or my neighbors honking their horns. That's not necessary. We're having Zen time over here. Do you want to grow indoors, outdoors? What works for you? How do you grow your plants? Do you like to water often? Not too often? Do you have a lot of light? Not a lot of light? All things to keep in mind. So you're going to have to do some research when it comes to picking out a plant that's going to work best for you. For me, I prefer outdoor bonsais. Bonsais that need a chill and need to stay outside during the winter time. I don't know why, that's just my taste. Here I have a green velvet boxwood that I picked up for a very good price, just at a big box store. And then over here, I love this. Look at it. Isn't it adorable? How stinking cute. This is another boxwood. This is the Mont Bruno boxwood. I'm going to go ahead and pot up both of these. But before I get going on that, when I'm working with bonsai and I have my trees picked out, I tend to like to sit back and look at them for a while. I think it's useful to get in, have a good look at the structure of the plant, get to see the various trunks. Are there any roots down in there? And just what direction do I want to go with it? What shape do I want to create with this? And I am looking more at this one over here to the right. The one on the left, I think, is just perfect. I absolutely love this little plant. So I probably won't be doing much as far as shaping or pruning goes with this one. This one up here, it's going to be getting a decent amount of pruning. I want to open it up, thin it out. Ultimately, I want it to have more of an airy vibe to it. I want it there to be more dimension, essentially, instead of just a few little trunks and then lots of foliage. I'm not going for a topiary look. That's going to be a little bit how this one comes out. This one, I'm going to try and be a little bit more drastic with it. I'm going to go ahead and pull this one right out of its pot and have a nice look at the roots. These look like some pretty good roots. That's a nice, healthy plant. It's not necessarily pot bound. It's just like right on the cusp of being pot bound, but not quite there. So for bonsai, with me, I'm trying to create something that looks like it's aged. I want to make a planter that has a tree in it that looks like an old tree. That's kind of the whole point. And this is rarely something where it's start to finish and you're done. It's an art form, it's a hobby, it's something that you do for years. So starting the bonsai isn't necessarily going to give you this beautiful plant you wanted right from the very start, unless you can find something like that cute little stinker over there to the left. Oftentimes, patience is a big part of it, and that's some of the joy of the bonsai. Now I have this out of its pot and kind of get a better look at it and see there's a nice thick stem running off the trunk over there and then one over here. Even some potential for having some exposed roots when I have that planted. See about that. For starters though, I'm just going to get going with pruning. Usually I don't like to trim off more than a third to up to half of the foliage or trunk at a time. It also just depends on the plant, what's going on with the roots, and how much I think it can take. The process of starting the bonsai of something that's supposed to be so calming and tranquil, pretty traumatic for the plant. That is one thing about it. It's not like typical gardening where I'm just going to take this and pot it up into something larger and nurture it. I'm definitely going to be nurturing the plants, but they're going to be going through some things in the process of getting them going. So down here I can see there's a little piece that needs to go because it's taking away from the fact that I want these to look like trunks. Depending on the plant, you can save your clippings. You might be able to air layer them or root them to start more in the future. I don't really need to do that with these. But that might be something to keep in mind if you want to keep working on them and making more and more of them. Like this, this is a decent start. Could get that going into something cute in the future. Go ahead and take that tag off there. Kept the tag on so I would make sure I could remember what it was called for the video, but that can come off now. Looking in here, see that stem? that can go. That's just getting in the way of having the view of these multiple trunks here. Okay, I already screwed up. I did a whole bunch of pruning and thought this was recording, and it was not. So, oops. It's okay. The entire pruning process doesn't really even need to be filmed. The main thing here is I'm trying to open the plant up. If there are any spots inside the trunk where there are some tiny leaves coming out of these stems, I went ahead and removed those because having little leaves coming out from down low kind of messes up the perspective, because want a bonsai to look like it's an old aged tree, like taking a great big piece of nature and put it into a tiny pot, trying to miniaturize it. That doesn't work if you have little leaves growing up the stem here. Not for this, not for the way I'm trying to do this. I came in, removed more and more stems from around here and over here and over here, basically, like I mentioned before. I'm just trying to, for starters, open it up. I want it to be open and airy and have that dimension and depth to it, not just a bush. And sometimes while I'm doing this, I'll get to a point where I sit back and stop and just kind of rest and look at the plant for a while before I decide what I'm going to keep doing with it. Other times even I'll draw out a sketch that can be useful. And then I make sure to remind myself that when this is done with its first pruning, it's not going to look like the finished final product I have in my head. Because what's really going on here is I'm doing this initial pruning, and that's just to start the plant off on the path to looking like what I want it to look like someday. I see so much more in here that I want to prune. Sometimes I'll stop myself and just go, you know what? That this is okay for now. Don't always have to get the full prune done from the very beginning if it's not a plant where you have to do a lot of chopping on. And this isn't. Like, this doesn't look too bad as it is. One thing that I would change is I would like to refine the shape of the plant. So coming through and getting these growths off that are sticking out really far and trying to keep things more into the proper dimensions. I know it's safe to do this because I haven't really picked out my apex. My main focal point of growth within these branches. I haven't really decided on that yet, but I have an idea. So like if I were to want to wire this, I know that here's a good branch right here that would be good for wiring. And if I were to do that, then this piece right here would come out. This branch over here would probably go over there and do that with that one. The problem is this branch over here, it doesn't have quite as much flexibility in it for wiring. So I may not end up doing any wiring with this one at all. I probably won't, because I don't have any wire. I might run to the nursery real quick just to grab some, because I also need to pick up a few other little things. But for now, this isn't a bad start. I like the direction this is heading. Okay, and I've gone and actually grabbed my actual bonsai scissors. It doesn't really matter what you use, as long as it's something that's nice and sharp. That's all that matters. You don't have to have anything fancy, especially if you're just getting into it, then, you know, why spend the money on something that's expensive? You can get a decent pair of bonsai shears for like, about $15 to $25, somewhere in there. I tend to like the ones that are longer instead of having the really big loop handles, just because it makes it easier to get in further into the plants if you're working with something really big and bushy. You can get in with a pair that's more narrow like this and do more kind of fine detailing. I'm just kind of keep turning the plant and seeing how I like it, and I also try and keep in mind the perspective of when it's going to be potted, like what direction it's probably going to be viewed from. I will probably more than likely have it something like this. See this angle, that wouldn't really make much sense. Potentially could pot it up over here from this side, but I think I just like it the other way better. If I were to be doing something much more drastic and dramatic here, I could. I'm not going to do this in this video, but this growth over here, you might be able to see when you look at this how this growth over here on this side of the plant, everything over here, has more of a sweeping leaning habit, whereas over here it just looks different. Do you get what I'm saying? It's almost like the two don't necessarily go together, and this is where wiring would come in really handy. I'm out of wire, so I'm not really going to be messing with it right now. But if I wanted to get really drastic and dramatic with this, I could come in and cut this. I shouldn't have opened the scissors up like that. I could come in and cut this entire piece off, get rid of that, attempt to root it, so not to be wasteful, and then readjust this when it's planted and start training these right here as my leads into something that would have more of a swooping habit. I just don't like to wire boxwoods that often. It does depend somewhat on the type of boxwood, but something about their bark, when these get wired, it tends to leave wire marks for a pretty long time after you're able to remove the wiring from them. And I think that this already has a lovely enough shape to it where I'm just not going to bother with it. And like I said, I don't have any wire right now anyways. As I mentioned before, I'm going to keep going through here, making some more cut just to get the plant a little bit more balanced.
Okay,
that's enough pruning for right now. I went ahead and I pulled it off the table and just kind of set it in my lap and worked with it a little bit. Also, I wanted to mention the only reason this is out of its pot is because the nursery container for this plant, it sat down in there so far. I just pulled it out for demonstration purposes so everybody would be able to see what I'm doing a little bit better. You don't need to remove the plant from the pot to do the pruning. It's actually probably better you leave it in the pot so it has more stability while you're going through that part. But now, here comes the part that I know is probably going to seem very drastic, potentially upsetting to people, but it's just part of the process, and that's root pruning. Time to come in here, get these roots loosened up, and cut back. It's just, like I said, it's part of it. It's going to be okay. There are various ways you can do this. Traditionally, a lot of people use a chopstick. It's not like it's not going to be a bonsai if you don't use a chopstick. I really like the root rakes. This is a single-pronged one. There are ones that have two prongs on them, which are really useful for doing really big root balls. But just a single-pronged one is going to be fine for something like this. Seeing right now a root up top that I really like. Can you see this? Just right above the blade here. I think that might be able to do something kind of neat with that. But while this has had quite an extreme chop to it, it's really, for a bonsai, it's not much. It's not much at all. I try and do this as gently as possible, but sometimes it's kind of hard to be gentle when doing one of this size. If I'm working with a plant that's really, really root-bound, then that's when I'll come in with a little saw and just cut that root ball. Again, I know it seems extreme, but remember, you're putting these into very, very, very shallow planters, so that's just kind of the nature of the beast. First, I like to go through with my little root rake and loosen things up as much as possible first, and then see what I have to do to really get these to a point where I can fan them out and spread them out into a pot. Okay, these roots have been pretty well cleaned out. I went ahead and did the rest of it off camera. It takes a while. It takes a lot of patience sometimes. It wasn't necessary. You get the point. Get those roots cleaned out. I tend to always err on the side of having more roots than less, so first I try and get as much of the soil out as possible before cutting them, like I had mentioned doing before. Because sometimes it's helpful to go ahead and get the pot out and start situating it in the pot and then being able to see how much more really needs to be taken out to make the plant fit. The whole point here is to be able to get these roots, to be able to fan out, and basically they need to be in an oxygen-rich environment. They don't want to be compacted down. That's not going to be good for the plant. So this way they can fan out and grow and fill that pot. And this is just about right. I could probably maybe take off just a smidge more from down below so that this will lay a little bit more flat in the pot, but that's pretty darn close to what I had been thinking about doing with this. I don't mind that. There's still a lot of root on there, but that's good. That's going to be good for this right now. Even though this is sitting in here in a way that I like, it's also important to keep in mind that there's going to need to be a layer of soil in the bottom of this before the actual plant goes in there. Not very much, but a nice thin layer, and once that's in there, that's going to have this up even higher. So that's why I'm going to go ahead and thin out the underside of this just a little bit more, just that will sit down further into the pot. And when it comes to picking out the pot, really that's a matter of personal preference or what style of bonsai you're doing. There are hundreds, if not thousands, of different methods. People spend decades studying this art, their entire lives. It would be impossible to cover that all in one video. This is just kind of how to get things started. A very practical, easy, beginner's manner of way of doing things. So I'm not going to go over the different like growing shapes and techniques other than pruning it out. And should I do wiring on this, I'll do that in a separate video. Because like I said, I don't even have the wire right now, so I couldn't even do it. The next thing to keep in mind, and to have done and prepared before you do all this to your poor little plant over there. So for starters, two drainage holes is usually best. They need a ton of drainage. It's really important that the soil drains very, very well. You may notice that there are four other holes. There's one here, and one there. That is for securing the plant. If I were to be putting a plant into this pot that were so big that it couldn't really be held and it would just flop around because you don't have a lot of space down here to get the plant packed in to make it steady and secure, then you would run a wire. Well, this got dirty. Then you would take a long wire, run it through here, and then up back through here, the same thing over here, and then you would have a wire sticking out from each end right here and right here, then you would take those wires and pull that back around the plant once you have that in there and potted, and that will help hold it down. Now, I'm not going to do that with this boxwood right here, but I thought it was important to mention it. Also, with these drainage holes, it's generally always a good idea to put some screening over those. So just hard plastic screening, some wire wrapped through it, and then that just goes right through these holes. And you take that wire, pull it, and press it into place nice and tight, and that is going to keep the potting mix from rushing out the bottom of the pot and making a big mess. There you have your plant centered, off to the side, personal preference, and again, that goes back to the different techniques and different styles, if that's something you're trying to follow. I'm just going based off of the aesthetic that I want to see, and I usually like to have my plants off-centered with a little bit of a gradual slope. It just, I don't know, creates a better field of depth. It's just my preference, personally. All right, so now it's time to go ahead and get this potted up. When it comes to picking out your soil, there are a lot of variables. It's really something that's worthy of its own video. I already had a whole bunch of this very sandy soil blended up in my wheelbarrow from when I was potting up some coconut palms in a video that came out, I don't know, a week or so ago. Maybe one or two videos prior to this one. And that's a fine soil for something like a boxwood. I did make some changes to it though. I added some, those tiny little red spots that are in there. Those are little lava chips. Traditionally, most soils used for bonsai are technically soilless, meaning that it's usually just types of gravels, essentially. Blends that are made up of things like lava stones, pumice, some granite chips, those sorts of things. And the whole point of that is to have excellent drainage. You're essentially growing your plant hydroponically when you do it that way. There are pros and cons to using those sorts of blends, and I highly suggest that do your research when picking out your soil blend. Like I said, this is going to be fine for the boxwood. Something to keep in mind is that these plants are generally going to be in these pots for anywhere from 2 to 5 years. You can sometimes push them longer than that. Because of that, it's really best to avoid a blend, a soil that has a lot of organic material in it. I do a lot with azaleas, which really like a nice composty organic soil. The problem with using something that has organics in it, like compost, is that over time those break down and they compact, and they really impede how well things are going to drain, and that can be detrimental to the plant. So the main thing, really good drainage. I've said it many times, it's because it's very, very, very important. And because different plants like different soils, it would be really hard for me to say in this video what kind of soil you should use for your plant. That's really, it's going to depend on what kind of plant you're using and your growing style. How often do you like to water your plants? What's your climate like? Those are things I couldn't possibly know about everybody who's watching these videos. You saw I already put a very thin layer of soil down in there. See, I was talking about how this is still up kind of high, and that's okay with a bonsai. It's okay for them to be up kind of high. The main thing is I want to make sure that these roots are flattened out really well, fanned out really well at the bottom, so that they will all sit in contact with that soil. That way there won't be any like air bubbles or air pockets would be really hard to fill in. A bit ago in the video, I had mentioned that I was going to stop where I was with the pruning because I wanted to go ahead and actually get this in the pot and set it down so I could get a better look at to how this is going to be when it's leveled down lower, and because I could adjust the angle. When it was in that nursery container or just in the solid root ball, it was growing at a bit of an angle. I came in here and removed some soil very slowly and gently from around these roots in here. I really like how those roots look. I would like for them to be more exposed. And now this is no longer at an angle. When it's sitting flat like this, I have a whole different appreciation for the shape. Whereas before I was talking about how, if need be, could remove this entire trunk over here and train these to grow off to the side in a fun swooping manner, that would still look great. But now that I'm able to have this down level in here, I have a whole different appreciation for the shape. That's why I had stopped with the pruning, because I want to be able to get in here, position it, get a different appreciation, a different perspective. And now I'm just going to come in here and get this filled in with this nice gritty soil. Sometimes I take my fingers and just gently will kind of lift up some of those roots if I have a lot of roots in the pot. I know the soil's working its way in between everything, but for the most part, watering the plant in should handle that. Sure, get that down in all the corners, all the way around everything. And I have been pulling out some of the bark chips when I see them. Those are just remnants of the soil I'd mix up for potting up the coconuts. That's just because, like I had mentioned, having organic materials in the soil can lead to things being a little bit more tricky down the road. Certain things we have to think about that often with just regular houseplants, right? Because they need to be repotted pretty much every other year. But with something that's going to remain in its container for a much longer time, have to keep in mind how whatever you're using is going to break down. Hence why most traditional blends for bonsai don't have organics in them, because then you don't have to worry about things breaking down. And you end up with a lot of oxygen being able to get around the roots that way too, which just really helps develop a much healthier plant. And then all that's left to do is I'm going to water this in gently but thoroughly. Want to make sure that the water goes through there at least 3 times. It's also why I haven't cleaned the pot off and there's still some mud on there, because chances are there's going to be some spillover because I haven't top dressed this yet. And then finally, a nice top dressing of some lava stone. You don't have to top dress. A lot of people don't. It's my preference to always put something on top of the soil because it just helps finish them off. It can help prevent runoff of soil over the surface if maybe you get a little heavy-handed with watering, things like that. And then it provides some protection as well to any exposed roots that weren't exposed before. Now that I have this potted up, like I think I mentioned before, I can see a lot of potential for what I would do with this when it comes to wiring. And with it being a boxwood, I had mentioned they do tend to hold on to the kind of like scarring indentations from wiring for a pretty long time. But I'm probably still going to do it because I just think that there could be some neat shapes made out of this. So I'm not going to do any more pruning right now, even though I do see several spots in here that I would love to remove and make it look a little bit more pretty. I'm going to go ahead and wait, because once I have the wire, I'll be able to put that down in there and start wrapping it and play around with the shape a little bit more, and I'll have a better idea of what I want to do. So this is good for right now. Okay, but what about this one? This cute little nugget. So sometimes you're at a nursery and you just get lucky and you find just the perfect little tree. That's what happened here. I don't really see myself doing much of anything with this one, at least not right now. I'm essentially just going to be repotting this one, not doing anything fancy. It's just going into a different pot for right now. Y'all already know the drill. I just did it with the other one. There's some mesh in the bottom. I'm going to go ahead and pull this out, and I actually may not even need to do much with these roots. I don't. See that? That's like almost a perfect fit. A situation like this where I don't really need to do much with the roots, I'm only going to slightly loosen this root mass up. I do want to make sure that it's going to be able to grow out, because using a very airy mix, and I'm working it down somewhat. That's just because it has this amazing root structure on it already, just as it is without any type of training or anything, and I want to make sure that that stands out. So I want this to be raised up, so I need to clean out this lower area so that can stand out better. Find my direction. I think it looks good like that. Just bring it over and set it in there. It'll be displayed with this flat side in the front, so I want to make sure to adjust it properly. Look at that. Simple. I'll backfill it and we'll talk about the care. That was too easy. Just the perfect plant. It was ready to go. Now, I don't plan on necessarily keeping this in this pot. I think that I could actually do something much cooler with this. The reason I wanted to start it off in this pot, I didn't want to look at it in the nursery container just because, I mean, look at it. That's not fair to leave it in that black pot. So I wanted this one mounted up very high because I'm going to very slowly pull that gravel back over time and try and expose more and more roots. And eventually I want to get that trained over a stone of some sort. And when I get to that point, I'll be pulling it and putting it into a different container. It's kind of a long process. I don't know if I'll be getting to that this year or not, but I'm going to start the process of getting that gravel pulled back and starting to get those roots trained to be up and exposed. There are a lot of different methods that people use for training roots and exposing them. It's kind of a big thing to get into, so I don't think I'm going to talk about that much in this video. Essentially, it's just something you want to do slowly. You can layer moss over the roots and slowly pull that back and start to train them, things like that. I'm just going to be using gravel for right now because it's what I have around. So there's the planting aspect of what I go through and my whole process of deciding how I like to do things. Not really going to go over the care on these because they're pretty specific. If you want to know what I do with my outdoor bonsais or specifically the boxwoods, comment down below and I could do a separate video on that maybe. However, for bonsai in general, there are a few standard things to talk about. One, as I mentioned, the soil. That blend, there's not much to it, right? So it's important to remember to fertilize. Get a well-balanced fertilizer that's made for bonsai. Oftentimes, those need to be used generally, like, weekly. You can just follow the directions on the packaging. It's not nothing complicated, but it is important to do that because there's not a lot of nutrient when you're working with an organic material. It's just important to remember to stay on top of the fertilizing. It's really more going to be about the time of year, though. So, for the most part, these would be fertilized spring through, well, I'd say till about late summer. that's usually when I stop with my fertilizing on these plants, and that's just because they don't need as much fertilizer or anywhere near as much water fall and winter. They'll be in more of a rest mode. Also, a lot of bonsai typically are not plants that you water really the same as you do typical houseplants, but it does, again, depend on what kind of plant you're growing. Typically, I let them dry out much more between waterings than I would a regular houseplant. But again, like I said, that's going to depend on what plant you're growing. So let me know if you actually want specific care videos. That's something I could do, but for the most part, I just want to talk about the planting up process, just kind of some of the very basic aspects of things. I could have put some structures, some hardscaping into these containers, like some rocks, bigger stones, something like that. I don't really have any stones laying around right now that really jumped out at me and made me want to use them, so I didn't. But that's something I can always add in the future. Same thing with little statues, little mud men, the pagodas, and things like that. Companion planting is a lot of fun with these. There are lots of little types of hostas, and even this syngonium, the super dwarf pixie, which I use in a lot of my Terrarium Tuesday videos. Excellent companion plants. There's a lot of companion plants to pick from. Even just sheets of moss work really well. Just depends on your aesthetic and what you want to do. Then the last thing I wanted to mention is to pay close attention to the nature of your soil. Sometimes you can end up with a mix that is going to seem like it's dry up top. So you'll think that you need to water the plant, but it might still be wet down below. So that's why it's really important to have something that's evenly blended and something that drains really well and is just very homogeneous. So the first several times you water, that's something to pay attention to. So I could be thinking, oh, it's time to water this because the surface, or like, you know, however far I can get my finger down, then there feels dry. But sometimes that's not the case. It can help to use a wooden skewer, like a kebab stick, something, a chopstick, just something absorbent. Stick it down in there all the way down. Give that a minute or so and pull it back up, and you'll be able to see the difference on that stick where the soil was wet versus dry. Moisture meters are I don't know about moisture meters with bonsai. The soil is very, very airy, and the moisture meters can be problematic in certain ways sometimes, but it's worth a try. I've never really messed with those with my bonsais, but give it a shot. I don't know. Comment down below. Do you use them for your bonsai? What are your thoughts? This video is just about getting everything started anyway. So that was the basics, getting them planted up, what to do with the roots, making sure the drainage is proper, kind of a rundown on the soil blend. I actually have a couple more bonsais that I'll be doing in this weekend's vlog. They're going to be really quick and simple. And if I find a stone that I like for this, I may pull this and start to get working on the root training. I don't know, but you know, the vlogs aren't typically focused on one thing, so we will see what happens there. But comment down below, what are some of your experiences with your bonsais? What are some of your favorite plants to work with, to your zones or in the house? What do you find to be the most hardy? What have you struggled with the most? Let's get a conversation going down there so everybody can kind of learn together, feed off of each other. And y'all know the whole YouTube thing. Like the video, I appreciate it. Makes a big difference for the channel. Thank you, and subscribe as well, and hit that notification bell. That way you know when new videos come out. And on my social media is linked down below. I use Instagram way more than anything else. I don't typically do a lot with the bonsai on this channel. I have several plants, well, more than several. Something, this is actually what got me into gardening. If you guys want more of these videos, but I mean less informative than this, because I think we kind of covered the basics there, let me know. If not, then I'll just return to it just kind of being my quiet guilty pleasure that I don't do on the channel. You know, that's lit up from the side. Yeah, it's because it's starting to get dark out, which means it is time to go. So hope everybody's doing well, having a great day and a great life, and everything's just going beautifully for you. And of course, as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye-bye.